Okay, let's see. We still don't have any power. I might actually have to make a biofuel generator just to get it going. Let's see. So, how does this work exactly? I am unsure. Well, having a battery should solve the problem. Now, do I have to fuel this? Okay, so furnace empty. So I assume I just have to chuck in a furnace tank. I'm just gonna chuck in carbon. I mean, we can get a whole bunch of it. Holy crap, that thing can hold a lot. And that's fueled for a little while. So we're just gonna wanna store this. I wonder if I can turn this off. The battery status charging. I like this power system. Eventually, we're going to have to find a better way of doing this. Wait, no, you cannot. You can't turn the portal off? Does the portal just have a consistent drain? Because if so, that kind of sucks. I guess I could just, like, disconnect the wire. I'm just going to disconnect the wire, at least for the time being. We'll just keep a charged battery sitting around. Okay, let's see. So, we needed to do what exactly? Find us heroes. Reach the decoded coordinates. Oh. Oh, that's just my base. I see. Archives terminated. Select new task. Begin encryption. Decoding. 16, 16, 16. Message follows. The traveler finds their wings. Fly to us and claim your place among the stars. That is off-planet. Alright. Well, let's get you out of the dirt. Let's see. I bought this game the day it came out. Played for 10 hours. Is it worth coming back to it? It's still the same game that you bought years ago. God, it's been like 2 years, too. At the same time, it's kind of its own beast now. And I would say considerably better for it. Honestly, it reminds me of Starbound. Like, I don't know how many of you guys played Starbound at launch, but it was pretty bad. It wasn't, like, irredeemably bad, but it was definitively, like, not fun. It had very little content. It was buggy. It was crashing. They frequently deleted saves and broke things and so on and so forth. And now it's like a completely different game. Does that make it better? Yeah, it is actually considerably better. It's got more crashes, but it's also got a lot more content, a lot more interesting things to do. The base building itself. The base building itself is such a wonderful addition. And I hope they keep adding to it. I mean, they have. The whole power system here and the base resource gathering, that's really cool. And I can very much see them, like, over the next, like, 2-3 years, getting this to the point where it's actually a pretty good game. Things that it still needs, definitely more interesting planets. They all are still... they're better than they were when the game first came out, but they're still kind of boring. You know, they're just big, empty spaces. Yeah, it's been almost 3 years. Cripes. But you know, empty spaces dotted with, like, little locations to go to. And while that isn't necessarily bad, it doesn't really, like... It isn't particularly interesting to just drive or fly around a planet and so on and so forth. It's better to just, you know, pick a location and then stick there until you need something else. But... Like, I still have more to do and more ways to approach it and more ways to, like, move around and stuff. You get vehicles, you've got little mods that you want to farm for, little side quests to actually give you things to do. It's still, ultimately, this lengthy Skinner box with... little variation, but it's a very zen game that you can just load up for a couple hours and be like, yeah, I accomplished things for a while, and it was fun. Not the most substantive experience, but it was fun. I think I can get up into those control towers. You can definitely get into these, though. This Ouija already punched his way into these. No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, cargo pod. We get antimatter. That's handy. I was saying the frame rate here is a little on the choppy side. I've got a new computer sitting behind me that I haven't assembled yet. I don't entirely know how I'm going to do that. That might just be something for tomorrow. Hey, warp cell. That's nice. Okay, but let's go check this out. Log damaged. Part records available. Wow, this frame rate is really bad. A signal has led me to the wreck of a freighter, colossal fragments of metal scattered across the landscape. Were these messages nothing but the misfiring circuits of a long-forgotten rune? Nestled among the debris, I find the pilot's log, unblinking, awaiting input. Quest log. Ah. Instead of displaying this ship's log, the terminal spits out a strange sequence of numbers. They are followed by a short message. The anomaly comes from for the stars. Take flight. A schematic for a hyperdrive is attached to the end of the message. I pull the blueprint from the computer, but this hyperdrive blueprint is for a conventional starship, not a freighter of this size. Someone placed this here after the crash, hoping it would be found. Okay, so I need some more microprocessors. I knew holding onto those other microprocessors was a good idea. Okay, so... purchase microprocessors. We've already got the chromatic metal I need. So let's just head for that. And get off this lag planet. I don't know. Yeah, computer assembly stream. I could do it. I gotta figure out how to stream from my phone to my computer. Because chances are what I do is just have Shell use my phone as a camera. And she'd film while I put the whole thing together. We tried recording me building the current computer I'm using 2 years ago, but I don't think it didn't take. The audio was bad. And I think I was lazy. And I think this time around I'll actually try and, like, set it up and stream it or something. Because that could be kind of fun. Probably a giant waste of time, but still. Well, not giant waste of time, but still. Okay. So it's gonna just keep yelling at me about that until I go away. Let's see. Where's the station? Huh. There's like a dot there. Like I'm seeing what looks to be like a small sphere out this direction. Oh, that's probably one of the moons. Let's see, what are jade peas? Jade peas are food. Okay. Nope. Egg space station. Damn it. It won't let me take that space station. Probably because it's on the other side of the planet. Stop trying to bring me to Altorial. God damn it. I guess we just have to wait until we go around the planet or something. Maybe if I just, like, shoot out here. That'll make it easier. Because I don't want it to approach the planet, because it's going to be hard to, like, slingshot around. Though, Now that I'm thinking about it, a slingshot maneuver would actually be really cool. Okay. This is kind of zen. I'm looking forward to really cranking up my pulse engine speed, though. Being able to, like, truly zip around the stars will be nice. Gonna need to unlock those side missions first, though. Probably also fuel this thing up. Let's see, what do I need for this? Tritium. Oh, well, I've got tons of that. Ah! Wait, space station's up here. Oh, it was in front of the planet the entire time. Well, that makes my life a little bit easier. As we'll pop open the tritium superclusters, or hyperclusters. Anything else in my inventory that I really, like, care to work around? Nope. See, the bit rate while warping is real bad. Oh, yeah. Twitch and encoding software in general really does not like, It really does not like anything that moves fast or, like, lots of bright colors. See, wonder what is the cheat engine link I use. I actually have been using the No Man's Sky save editor. It's a little bit more reliable. Okay, does this guy have anything new? Probably not. No? He's got another movement module. Thank you. Let's see. Ship-related stuff? Yeah, let's see if there's any cool starship-related tech. Oh, but if you find a freighter you want, that's going to be a little bit harder. We'll grab it. Yeah, I could go looking. We could go looking for a functional cheat engine. Now, can I move these? Yeah. Let's see, I want to link these together. Okay, so that is jetpack tanks, 200. Yeah, sprint distance. I really wish one of these was sprint speed as well, but oh well. Anyway, I can now fly for a while longer. Hi. That's disconcerting. I'm pretty sure I can't. Yeah, no, invisible walls. Cool. Nope! I reject. Shit. Okay, there's my ship over there. I might be able to reach it. Oh. Okay. I'm standing on nothing. It's like the world just unloaded on me. Alright, whatever. It's... No... I'm like on a ramp. Yep, no, never mind. Damn it. Yeah, so I think I'm just gonna have to avoid weapons boxes. That's frustrating. Okay, well. Give me a second. We're just going to do a thing. Seeing as I can't... is it slot 2? Yeah, it should be slot 2. Save file 3HG. This gets confusing. Anyway, where's my multi-tool? There's my multi-tool. I'm just gonna give myself a better multi-tool for the time being. Because, well, I'm gonna give myself a ridiculous multi-tool. We're just gonna generate, like, twice, see what we get. Enable all slots, and I have no idea what these are. I'm going to set my base scan to 10. Mining to 10. Damage to 10. We're just gonna make the most broken thing ever. And we'll find an actual proper multi-tool at a later date. Sounds good to me. Let's see. That's probably fine. Let's see. Main. Save changes. I should be able to reload that whenever I want. Yeah, because if I can't buy a single multi-tool, I'm just going to give myself a good one for the time being. But yeah, so if you want to get access to the save editor, it's just... You should be able to search No Man's Sky save editor and find it. I don't know, I found it through a Steam discussion. I guess I could throw it in Discord real quick. Let's see, do we have the No Man's Sky? No Man's Sky. There we go. Should work. Yep, okay. So if any of you guys want to get super cheatsy with it, you're welcome to. Is it the GitHub version? Yep, should be. Normally, I try to avoid, like, super cheats right off the bat and, like, force myself to grind a little bit. But, again, after 150 episodes of No Man's Sky, I don't know if I care as much. Yeah, I think it's the one by Goat Fungus. Oh, hey, by the way, do we have a mod in chat that would be willing to change the Discord link? Because now it's discord.gg/wanderbots. I mean, technically, you can have the random numbers one, too, but I've got a legit, like, Discord link. Because I got a proper Discord partnership. I'm excited about that. I haven't really, like, used it or advertised it that well, but still, exciting for me. Okay, so this guy had the extra exosuit speed thing. Okay, so... Is there anything else that I care for? Because I really only want to buy speed modules. Because I gotta go fast. So it doesn't look like it. Okay, so let's... Let's move those there. Alright, so now I can fly. And then let us save. Oh, I love this music. It's super good. So what do we need next? What I should probably do is actually wait for one of these guys to pop out. Because I'm gonna need more copper. I know that much. Hello, God. Oh right, we should probably also see how broken my multi-tool is. Hey, he sells microprocessors for extremely large amounts of money. That's not cool. Well, nothing he has is useful. Even with the extra jetpack upgrades, it really does not feel like it's that tremendous. What was I doing up here? I was shop. Oh, right. I was going to look at my multi. That thing does not seem fair. Okay, microprocessors. So it looks like the price of microprocessors around here just sucks. I'm out of money. Why do I have no money? Oh, right, because I spent it all on a ship. What can I do? What can I sell? Do I have anything worth anything in my inventory? The answer is a hard... I could sell all this chromatic metal. I kind of need it for things, but it's worth... It's worth an amount. Freaking sure, why not? Microprocessors. I gotta go make some money. Let's see, so we want to install tech. Teleport receiver would be nice, but let's go with the... Oh no, I needed that chromatic metal. Ah! 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 I made a mistake. Sup, dude? Do you sell copper? Let's see, am I sure that editor is safe? It has never screwed me over, but make backups anyway if you're paranoid. That's my usual strategy anyway. Okay. And I'm gonna warp back down. Oh, do I mean virus? Honestly, usually stuff I get on GitHub is safe. I don't know. Yeah, I could cheat the metal in. Hmm. Okay. I'm just gonna land somewhere on the planet and we'll just try and grab the copper while we're there. Might as well look for some buried tech modules anyway. But nah, I can't guarantee for certain it doesn't have viruses, but I've been using those save editors for years, so... Or that save editor for 2 years now, I think? And I've never run into any issues. What the hell? Where's the planet? Huh. The hell? Okay, there is some land. I'm just gonna assume this planet is busted and we'll just try a different one. That's really confusing. I guess we can try again now. What is this? What's silver in it? Oh, it's just like a round asteroid. Looks like a weird moon or something. Okay. There it goes. There's the land. It just totally didn't render for whatever reason. This was weird. Life is weird. Okay, so do we scan for a structure? I mean, that looks like a structure right there. Looks like it's an obelisk, or whatever the equivalent of. Sup? Holy smokes, that's a big thing. A Falk! Got any other critters nearby? I know we've got at least one or two aquatic critters that I haven't scanned yet. Well, for now, let's at least look at this thing and utilize what I can. Might as well learn words. I do kind of wish the words that you'd learn from these knowledge stones was randomized a little bit. Because it'd be really amusing to find, like, it'd be really amusing to just get, like, utterly useless words like Windex. Like, you've learned the interloper word for Windex. Why? Okay, the Viking, Lukrong, blah, 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 blah. I place my palm on the monolith and stand back when it melts in response to my touch. Molten rock drips down the stone, exposing a hollow interior. Inside, I see riches that are beyond belief, ancient technologies, and cargo that would aid my journey. Suddenly, the voice of an ancient tribe shakes the ground I stand on. Eh, stand back. Ancient warriors who once worshipped here blessed my show of respect. The lava reshapes itself, forming an intricate plinth, and in front of me as it cools, the plinth is laden with gifts. The vision fades, but the gifts remains. cool. I get a Viking effigy. I like those. Okay, so while we're here, what do we got? We're looking for copper, not platinum. It's a sodium deposit. Star bramble, damaged machinery, paraffinium, star bramble, copper deposit. Real close, too. How fast can I mine down a tree? Not actually that fast. I was hoping I could do other things. Now is this is a completely no. This is the planet I put my house on. This is Wanderhome. I was just surprised because it's so sunny here. Anyway, we need a fair chunk of copper, so I'm just gonna grab what I can. Man, if you could combine this game with Empyrean, you'd have a pretty solid experience. What other games could you combine with No Man's Sky to make it, like, perfect? Honestly, Rebel Galaxy Outlaw might not be a bad combo as well. Because we've got another copper deposit over there. I'm just gonna load up on a whole bunch. Because we're going to need, like, boatloads of this stuff as we go forward. Eventually I'll buy a whole bunch, but I am suddenly skirting absolute poverty. Which, technically, would just take a reload to fix, but, eh. That'd be less fun. Let's see, combine it with Starbound. Honestly, I'm not actually sure if combining it with Starbound would change too much. Because I think both No Man's Sky and Starbound actually have very similar weaknesses. Which is to say they're almost too procedurally generated and they lack a certain level of... how do I describe it? By not having anything hand-designed, it ends up feeling more limited? Yeah. Inventory is full. Ah! Let's see. I could discard the metal plating and the carbon nanotubes. Discard the salt. I can get more of that elsewhere. But, like, what's a good example of a game with, like, really good handmade... Well, actually, Subnautica. Subnautica across the board is a hand-designed experience. You know, every area, even if it is just kind of this big, open, empty nothing, was made by somebody's, you know, hand intentionally and actually ends up feeling better as a result. I want to grab a bunch of these. Nope. I'm trying to do the... There we go, got it. Yeah, trying to do that jet boost is tough. Oh my god, we're gonna have a stupid lighthouse situation again, aren't we? Yeah, I'm gonna go over here. But, like, exploring environments in Subnautica felt very satisfying because there was a reason for all of it. And again, yeah, most of the time it really was just kind of empty nothing. Let's get rid of that. I don't know if we need the Fecium either. But still. Okay, what else do we got? I'm just gonna run for all the buried tech modules that we've got along this hill. The more structures I can research, the better. I still think it needs like giant megafauna as well. Stuff like space whales just floating around. Because I think that would actually make things a lot better. Vistas to see would help a lot. And not to detract, there are some like really nice views. Like this valley right now looks great. But like, I still think it should have like a giant uber mountain just hanging out right there. And then, like, in the distance, you can see, like, a space whale going going by overhead. Or freaking freighters, actually. I really wish you could see, like, the shadow of a freighter going by up in space. Because I think that actually would make a nice difference as well. See, No Man's Sky plus Satisfactory? That'd be pretty good. It does seem like they're trying to include some more of that. Let's see, do we got any? Aha! Unfortunately, I don't have the scanner modules to make shit tons of money here. We've got to go to a new system first. Dang. Okay, do we bust open the armor clam for living pearl? We could. Get rid of the silicate powder. Because I know you need living pearls. Loads of living pearls to make subs. I should probably maybe work on that. What is that thing? If I remember right, this is something kind of useful too. Crystal sulfide. God dang. Alright, whatever. Let's get rid of the metal plating and the carbon nanotubes. I can get more of them whenever I want.